Lord, as we lift you up, Lord, and lift her up for the things she has done, Lord, we thank you right now, Father, that you will be glorified in this place, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you will send a cloud, Lord God, send a cool breeze, Lord God, to cool us off, Lord, as we celebrate this evening. And we thank you, Lord God. We bind confusion, Lord God. We bind the enemy right now, any distraction, Lord God, that tries to stop this movement, Lord God. We pray that the peace of God will hit this place even now, God, in the name of Jesus. Because your word says we lift you up, God, that you will draw all men, God. So we thank you that you are faithful, you are good God, you are mighty God, and we all agree that we love you out here. In Jesus' name, and everybody said,
amen.
And everybody said,
amen.
Amen, amen. Come on, give yourself a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. We're going to have a wonderful time this evening. Is that all right? I think she want a celebration. How many of y'all agree with me? I think my auntie want a celebration. So we're going to celebrate. And I want to thank everybody for coming out today. But we're going to worship to every praise. Because how many of you know every praise belongs to our God, to our King? Hallelujah. Turn it up some. Come on, put your hands together. praise. Oh, look at the breeze. Look at the cloud. We thank you for the cloud, God. We thank you today. Amen.
Hello, everybody. Man, God is good, isn't he? Oh, my God. Aunt Sadie is just outdone. She just cannot believe what we are doing for her today. Oh, my God. This is so awesome. If you guys could stand where I'm standing, let me tell you, ain't nobody mad. Ain't nobody mad. Ain't nobody mad. Woo! What the devil? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I'm Pat McAllister LaDuff, and I am Aunt Sadie's niece. So Aunt Sadie is my dad's sister, and he was like a special, special person to her. And this is really a special moment for us. Just to hear that the person has been identified. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up for God. Give it up for our police department. And give it up for our community. Give it up for yourselves. We had so many detectives going on. I'm telling you, I think Chief ought to just hire us all. Because we did it. I mean, we did it. Man, I went right over to the corner and asked the lady of the night, what's going on with the white car? So what I say to Baton Rouge, what I say to the nation is, let this be the beginning. Our chief is starting something called Collective Healing, and it's a part of a program where you do just what we did. Don't let your loved one leave here and you haven't done your due to try to find out what happened. Somebody heard something. When you hear something, when you hear something, when you hear something, that's what I'm talking about. When you hear something, say something. I got stories after stories, texts after texts, phone calls after phone. Maybe it was this, maybe it was that. And here we are today. He's been identified. And we just want to also lift his family up, because just as shocked as we were to hear what happened to Aunt Sadie, I'm sure his family is just as shocked to hear that he did it. And so we just got to pray. And then we got to do what Aunt Sadie wanted us to do, and that is come together in peace. And we're going to keep this museum alive. Yes, we are. In the name of Sadie Roberts Joseph. It will not be boarded up and overblown. And you come out and you volunteer and you just step on over here, and when you see brass need to be pulled, you just pull it. You don't have to ask anybody. Okay? When you need to volunteer, you just come over here and volunteer. And when people are looking for a place to go, you say to the people with the group of camp kids, with the keeper children, go over to the museum so that we can learn our history and that we can pass it on to someone else. I love you guys, and just keep lifting us up. Thank you.
All right, we're going to introduce our first speaker, President of Louisiana State NAACP, Mike McClanahan. Let's give him a round of applause, everybody. And then we're going to go with the Chief of Police. He's going to start making his way over here. Thank you, Chief Paul, wherever you are.
I can tell you without a doubt, Sadie's saying, wow. Sadie's saying, wow. I've been out here many a time, and you know, a lot of time we struggle to get volunteers to come and help paint, and volunteers to come out and help pull weed, and volunteers to come out and speak about our history. This is a learning process about our history. No one should have to die and not know their history. Sadie was a walking historical book. She was a walking, talking thesaurus about anything about black. But Sadie did what we don't do. She lived life to the fullest. I can tell you that right now. She lived life to the fullest. She laughed, and she laughed often. Those of you who knew her, she was a quiet, soft-spoken person. She would say, Michael, about it. I can tell you what I think about it. And then she would have this laugh. She laughed often, but the thing that made Sadie a love of people is that she loved people. No matter who you are, or where you were from said he loved you unconditionally. So we must all do what Sadie did in her lifetime, because we know at some point in time that she was going to be born. But no one knows how they're going to leave. So from the time that you're born and the moment you leave, you should live life to the fullest. You should laugh and laugh often, but more importantly, you should love and love everybody. So on Sadie's way out, as I take my seat, I promise you, whoever did this to her, she was trying to get them some help. Sadie would oftentimes talk about the resources that you needed to better yourself in life. If you didn't have a GED or a high school degree, she would say, baby, go over there to that college and get yourself an education. She understood education was the key to get you up and out. She would say, if you didn't have a housing, baby, go around the corner. It's going to help you. She might call a politician on your behalf, Pat Smith, Judge John Michael Kendrick. She would call them for your help. But in the end, Sadie went home doing what she loved to do, help people. Help somebody along this way, and I promise you, your living will not be in vain. Yes, sir.
All right, and now we have Chief Murphy Fong.
You know, right now we know when we think about the body of work of Miss Sadie. And today we had a press conference. And when I heard her daughter talk, and I don't know if any of y'all heard the press conference today, by the show of hands. The first thing that came to heart was well done. Because when I heard her daughter speak, all I could think about is she get it from her mom. Did she speak well? Her mother was speaking through her. So, you know, when I learned about everybody who had something today about say about Miss Sadie, all of my police officers had a Miss Sadie story. And everybody in the community, and all the blogs on Facebook, on Instagram, all of the positive comments. What I pray is that what she stood for, the love this community had for her, and how this community responded by saying, we're sick and tired. And they picked up the phone and they called my detectives, family members, everybody who saw something. People who saw things on blogs, on social media, were sending it to us. Let's take that energy, let it become contagious. And let's start something different here in the city of Baton Rouge. Yo, we could make this happen. We gotta believe. There's too many violent acts that's happening in our community, where the perpetrator of the crime, before he or she committed it, communicated his intention to somebody. And no, he didn't pick up the phone and call law enforcement. You know who he told it to? Somebody in his inner circle. Somebody in his family. We know right now beefs and differences on social media that are being communicated. Let's pick up the phone. Let's call our pastors. Let's call nonprofits. Get together as a family. Look, I understand if you've been scared to call law enforcement. But call somebody. We can no longer allow this violence that's been holding our city back for so long to continue. Let's do it for Miss Sadie. God bless y'all and thank you.
Jones. He's right here sitting down in front. How old are you, Mr. Jones? How old are you?
contest.
He's always getting himself properly. That Bob, she was a great friend of mine.
Excuse me, ma'am, pardon me.
I never seen him. Just a few days before she encountered her latest few days here among us, I visited with her, and she visited with me. We talked. She was born in Wilkerson County, Mississippi. I was born in Laurel Hill, Louisiana. I was 1 mile south of the Mississippi line. To see what she's done, and under the situation under which we came, it's wonderful how it could be done. But I always listen to what my mother say, and apparently, say the parents say the same thing to her. Let your work speak for you. Let your work speak for you. Say was one person who lived that phrase out. She let her word speak for her. When you look at this crowd, the number of people out here today, don't you hear Sadie? Listen, don't you hear? It's all speaking for her. Let your word speak for you. Be like Sadie. Let your word speak for you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Jones. Give it up for Mr. Jones, almost 100 years old.
And now we'll introduce our singer.
That this song that I'm going to sing is very fitting for this occasion. And the title of the song is I Just Can't Give Up Now. There will be mountains that I would have to climb, and there will be battles that I would have to fight. Victory or defeat, it's up to me to decide. But how can I expect to win if I never try? Oh, I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me that the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to lead me. Never said there would be trials. Never said I would fall. Never said that everything would go the way I wanted to go. But victory or defeat, it's up to me to decide. But how can I expect to win if I never tried? Oh, I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I started from.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Lord.
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 Yes, Lord. Lord. Yes, Lord, we're going to keep fighting. Yes, Lord, we're going to keep moving.
Something here that's outside of the realm of a Baptist church. I'm going to say assalamu alaikum. Now that's the only Arab words I know, but I love the connotation. It's peace be unto you. And the response is peace be unto you too. Amen. I'm just grateful, first of all, just to be alive. How many of y'all are glad to be just be alive? To be in the land of the living? I come with you to celebrate the life and the legacy of a queen among us who walked among us for a season. What I love about her and what I want to say about her is that most of you saw the finished product after God had put her through the refinery. The trial, tribulations, the tears, the ups, the downs, the disappointments, the letdowns, the putdowns. After she had went through all of that, and he blessed her with this. Amen? So you see the end result of hard work determined. My challenge to you is to not let this just be a gathering and celebration of a legacy that has already been putting in the work. When I met her in a ditch picking up paper in Scotlandville. When I met her, she was in a ditch picking up paper, organizing a clean up the community campaign. This was almost 30 years ago. And the first thing she said to me was, Reverend Pitcher, the gloves are right over there. Now, she was the kind of person, those of you who really knew her, she worked hard and she expected you to work hard too, whether you wanted to or not. Her mentality was, if I can, you can. If I can get in the ditch, you can get in the ditch. If I can pick up paper, you can pick up paper. I don't care what your socioeconomic status is. If I can get down here, you can get down here. And was disappointed when you didn't. So not, our preachers, we have to... But I'm a quit, but I want to say this to you. I want to say this to you. I was bit by the boss a few days ago. And I looked up, saw this huge wasp nest.
Yes.
Now, if they wanted to, they could have really hurt me. But only one of them came down to get my attention because I had gotten too close. Every now and then, God does something like this to get your attention. You've been too complacent. The work has not been completed. You're too comfortable. So he'll reach down and he'll take one of your best and your brightest to get your attention. To let you know that it's still work to be done. There's still things that have not been yet accomplished. So don't get too comfortable on your laurels. And for those of you who left the hood, who live in your gated communities outside the hood, come by every now and then. Check on the folks who you left behind. Because unless you show them the attention that they need to get them out of the situation we used to be in, they're going to remain in the situation and we're going to keep on having stuff like this happen. You can say what you will of me. I don't know the brother. I don't hate the brother. I look at where the brother came from. I've been there, done that. Could have been me. The environment, the circumstance, the situation breeds folk like that. If we don't address the socioeconomic status of folk who are still in the hood, the educational status of people who are still in the hood, the lack of adequate health care, people who are still in the hood, we're going to keep on having events like this. God is going to keep on taking our best and our brightest until we wake up and realize nobody can save us for us but us. Oh, you ought to be clapping on that. Nobody can save us for us but us. Oh, this is, I like this gathering. There's a whole lot of folk here. But where will you be next week? And week after next? Where will you be then? Some of you, this is the first time you set foot on these grounds. I'm just keeping it real. Some of y'all, this is the first time y'all have been here. When she needed y'all to come and support, you weren't here. But now you're here. So what I'm saying to you, while you're here, make a commitment that this place is going to be bigger and better and last longer and have more impact than it did when Sadie was here because Sadie was here. Can I get a witness? Torch has been passed to this lady right here to carry on the work. And I'm hoping that she accept the responsibility. Her shoulders are wide. She can do it. But the responsibility of you is to do your part. Her motto was roll up your sleeves and get the job done. So in closing, I say to you, roll up your sleeves and get the job done. God bless you and God keep you, my friend.
Can we acknowledge how good God is, right? Right? Can everybody put their hands up on me? Everybody. Yes, let's wave to our museum because this is our museum for our community. And now we're going to welcome our Mayor Broom with our first prayer. Yes!
Good evening, everyone. I was invited to come up and pray for our city. I'm not ashamed to be a praying mayor. And I'm going to ask you to join your hearts with my heart as I pray for our city and our community. We all had a connection, most of us here, with Sadie. And I'm sure everyone could tell their own story about their connection with Sadie. But she was a woman of love. She was a woman of courage, and she was a woman of faith. She was a praying woman as well. So in honor of her faith and as a Christian praying woman, I am going to pray and ask you to join your hearts with mine as I pray for our city and our community. Would you do that? Father, we first of all come here. Many of us are here tonight. Our hearts are heavy because of what we've experienced in a loss. But Father, we recognize that the woman that we are here tonight to gather, to celebrate, lived a God-honoring life. She lived a life worth celebrating. She lived a life that emulated the principles of Jesus Christ. She emulated love, joy, peace, kindness, meekness, temperance, and faith. Lord, she demonstrated what you said in your word about not only loving you, but loving your neighbor as you love yourself. And so, Father, tonight we believe that her life was not lost in vain. Tonight, as a community, we speak love to the Baton Rouge community in honor of Sadie Roberts Joseph, Father. We speak peace to the Baton Rouge community in honor of Sadie Roberts Joseph and what she stood for. We speak nonviolence because she was a nonviolent woman. And because you have demonstrated to us over and over the power that love conquers violence. Love conquers hate. And so, Father, I ask that you would speak to each and every one of us here, name by name, person by person, family, friends, community, churches, lawyers, doctors, each and every one of us that represent the fabric of the Baton Rouge community. Speak to our hearts individually and collectively to tell us what we can do to empower our community, to leave a legacy honoring our sister, Sadie Roberts Joseph. Father, speak to our hearts this evening. Lord, we thank you for helping us to move on from here as a community, unified around a shared vision and a shared goal that our sister communicated regularly. We love you, Father, and we thank you for what's going to take place in this community. And it's in the name of Jesus that I serve. Amen.
Pastor Wesley, come on up. Pastor Lee T. Wesley from the Community Bible Baptist Church.
One of the sweetest, kindest, joyful, eloquent persons I've ever known was Sadie Roberts Joseph. While we mourn her death, the manner in which she left us, while we're saddened at her passing, at the same time, we have reason to rejoice. Of all the things we've heard about her, the most important one is this. She had a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. So here is the joy. Blessed is the dead who die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, they shall rest from their labor, and their works follow them. So we have reason to rejoice. Understand this. Nothing happens unless God allows it to happen or causes it to happen. Nothing catches God by surprise. Oops is not in his vocabulary. If it happens, he caused it to happen, or he allowed it to happen. The question that we need to ask ourselves is, what is the message we ought to get from what he allowed to happen? Because whatever he allows to happen is for a divine purpose. And I think one of the purposes in this instance is to bring us together as a people, to get us to understand that nothing positive is going to change in this community unless we make it happen. And we can't make it happen if we are fighting each other. We have to come together as one community in order to improve what's going on now. The violence, the killing, the crime, those of us who are people of faith, we have the power to stop it if we stop the infighting and begin to call on the name of the Lord, believing that he's going to hear and answer our prayer. That is my message to you. I love Sadie. I've known Sadie for over 30 years. We've worked together on a number of community activities, and she would be excited about what's happening here today. But this ought not be the end of it. It ought to be the beginning of it, because God has called us together as one people. Let's get the work done. Amen?
Hallelujah. Come on, give him a hand clap. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I sense the presence of God. Anybody sense that peace? Oh, there's a healing taking place right now. Forget about who's next to you for a minute and just give God the praise. And everything that's going through your mind and all the pain that you feel, just lift your hands and just release it. Hallelujah, God. My hallelujah, God. It belongs to you. Can I get a witness out here today? We honor you today. You deserve it, God. Oh, my God, come down and minister to your people, God. Work together for good, God. You deserve the glory, God.
Say it, God.
Belongs to you. We give it to you today, God.
Come on, say my hallelujah.
Come on, help me.
From the bottom of your heart, lift your voice. My hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Belongs to you. Receive it, God. You deserve it, God. In spite of God, you deserve it, God.
Everything I give you, Lord. Everything I owe you, Lord, it belongs to you.
Hallelujah.
It belongs to you.
Peace. Lay down, God.
go.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Everybody, come on, come on, come on, y'all, lift your voice, let's go.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, all God's people, continue to sing. Say,
my hallelujah belongs.
Come on, lift your voices like you know you're serving the real God. Say,
my hallelujah belongs to you.
Yes, we say, my hallelujah belongs to you. We're talking about the living true God.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Let's let him know he deserves it. Say it.
You deserve it.
Make it personal, Bad Rouge.
Sadie Roberts Joseph's hallelujah belong to him. And so today we say, to God be the glory for the things that he did in Sadie Roberts Joseph's life. She poured herself out. She gave herself away so that God could use her. And for every mountain that he brought her over, she was a humble community servant. She came out here and she bore her burdens in the heat of the day. She worked the work of he who sent her while it was day. And now that night has come, she can rejoice that her living was not in vain. And if we really want to pay testament, if we really want to love her legacy, then we have to stop the violence, stop the killing, stop the hurting, and redeem one another. She's all right now. She has a house now, not made with hands. In her final moments, she knew the fellowship of Christ's sufferings. But in the latter day, she shall know the power of his resurrection. Thanks be to God for this life well lived.
Okay, so, give it up. Y'all just helping me give it up now. I'm about to break down. Somebody better give it up. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Lift me up. Lift me up. Lift me up. This is tough. Lift me up. Lift me up. Hallelujah. Nothing like some good old love to give you strength. Woo, Jesus. Oh, Lord. Okay, okay. All right. Come on, Quinn.
Hallelujah. Precious Father, in the name of Jesus, Father God, we thank you. Thank you for this time of fellowship. We thank you for everyone that is here, everyone that is represented, every family that is represented here. And Father God, we thank you that Miss Sadie's death was not just a murder, was not just a death, but it was a seed planted. A seed planted that will produce a harvest, not of 30, not of 60, but 100-fold, Father. We thank you that the seed, those things that she planted on the inside of each and every person that she came in contact with, Lord God, we thank you that it will produce a a harvest. Their lives are changed. Their lives that she changed, that they will go and change others. That that would that, that seed process would continue to produce fruit and produce fruit and produce more fruit and produce more fruit, God. Father God, we thank you that a revival will take place within our city, within our communities, Lord God. That there was, that what she stood for was not in vain. That that peace she stood for is not in vain. We thank you that that peace, Lord God, that peace that surpasses all understanding will continue to permeate this land, continue to permeate these people, Lord God, that you're going to touch beyond a shadow of a doubt, that you're going to touch your people, Lord God, and that you're going to meet those very needs. We rebuke and we bind that, that poverty spirit or that jealousy spirit, that envious spirit, that doubting spirit, everything that goes against what you call that our will and our way for our lives, Lord God. We rebuke and we bind it and we send it back to the pits of hell where it belongs, Lord God. And we thank you that joy will continue to manifest itself. Peace will continue to manefest itself. A love beyond the shadow of a doubt will manifest itself. Because we know that there's no length, nor width, nor depth, nor height, Father, that can separate your love from us, Father God. And we thank you that eyes have not seen, nor ears have heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man the things that you have in store for us, Lord God. And we thank you that you're going to show up and show out that in the months to come, in the years to come, that this place and this city, this town, will grow and become what you have called it to be. And we just thank you for it right now. In Jesus' mighty, holy, and sovereign name we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we get ready to close it out, amen. We want to thank you on the behalf of my family, amen, for everyone that came out to support, to be there for my family. So we're going to pray for my family. I'm going to pray, and I need you to stretch out your hand as we begin to pray for my family, as we begin to pray that the strength of God, the courage of God, the grace of God begin to strengthen us. And as we praying for my family, I'm going to pray for your family, because there's so many of you out there that you done lost a son or a daughter to the streets, to violence. And you hurting today. And God want to do something supernatural today. This is not only just a celebration. This is a healing meeting too. And some things finna happen right now in the spirit realm. And we so excited. And we're going to begin to play this song. I'll pray for you and you pray for me. And we're going to turn this whole area into a prayer meeting. Because I believe prayer changes things. Can I get a witness today? We celebrate today. We celebrate today. So as I begin to pray, as the music begin to play.
You let me bring God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For you. Look at the person next to you and say, I want to pray for you. See, he said it earlier, the only way it stopped, that it stopped with us. We got enough people out here right now to make a change in Louisiana. Hallelujah. Somebody's crying. Hallelujah. Somebody out here worrying. Somebody frustrated out here today. But we stop by in the name of Sadie Robinson Joseph to encourage you. We want to speak life to you today.
You can depend on God
today. Oh, my God, my God. To pray for you. Come on, is anybody out there encouraged today? Just keep praying. Lord, we're going to keep praying. We're going to keep pressing, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm going to keep on praying. You cannot have our sons, our daughters. We saw the devil notice today that enough is enough. Can I get a witness? Somebody, he gonna see you through today. And you can depend on the person next to you to pray for you.
Now let me pray.
prophesy.
Come on, prophesy. Won't somebody look at the person next to you? I see you in the future. Hey! Hey! Somebody scream! I see your future today. And you look better. I don't care what the devil say. I see you walking in favor today. And prosperity too. And our family will encourage you today. We want to speak life to you today. Hallelujah. We depend on you, God. To see everybody out here through, God. Hallelujah. Pray for you. And this is what I want you to do right now. Grab a hand right now.
Bishop.
Hallelujah.
Riding on that airplane.
Hallelujah.
My.
Hallelujah. Just grab a hand right now.
Yeah.
And let's just watch God change things.
All we've been through.
Hallelujah, Lord God. Lord, we trust you to change things. I'll pray for you.
God said, tell me.
Look at the person next to you. And if you pray for me, something getting ready to happen. Hey. Watch God change things. Watch God change things, y'all. I'll pray for you.
You pray for me.
You pray for me. And watch God. Watch God. How many believe that today? How many believe that today? I'll pray for you, God. I'm going to pray to you. And you're getting ready to do something.
Watch God change things.
Oh, hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah. When you go back to your home,
just take a moment out to pray for you.
When you're on your lunch break, when you get back in your car, you ought to just watch God.
Watch God.
Oh, God. Just change things today, God.
You know what's going to happen if you pray for me?
What's going to happen? What's going to happen if I pray for you?
Just look at somebody.
Look at somebody. Look at somebody and tell them, I'll pray for you.
What's getting ready to happen?
You pray for me.
Watch God change.
Pray for me. We can make it if we pray together. Hallelujah, God. I'll pray for you.
Pray for you.
God, we thank you. Because you're getting ready to change some things. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Hey, hey, glory. Change. Louisiana, get ready to change. The world, get ready to change. Because of the believers. Hallelujah, God.
I want my friend Crystal to come.
Hallelujah. Where the sisters at out here? Where the prayer warriors at out here? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Where the men at out here? Where the warriors at out here? Hallelujah. I'll pray for you. And I can guarantee you something finishes. Change things.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Somebody ought to give them a wave offering now. Come on, just wave to them. I'm telling you, as you wave to them, that's a sign of surrender. That's a sign of worship.
Watch God.
Change things, God. Change hearts, Lord God. Change lives, God. I'll pray for you. And you pray for me. God, get ready. Watch God, watch God. Watch God, watch God, watch God, watch God. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Show off today, God. Hallelujah. Glory to God, glory to God. And watch God. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father. So I thank you right now for the anointing of God. I thank you for the Spirit of God. as we begin to worship you, as we begin to adore you, Lord God. I thank you that your presence came down, Lord God. So, Lord, there are many people out here today, Lord God. And, Lord, some of them are hurting, Lord. Some are disappointed, Lord God. Some need a touch, Lord God. Some need their situation to change, Lord God. And I know that ain't Sadie, Lord God, that she was standing here alongside me, God. She will offer this opportunity, Lord God, for somebody that don't know Jesus. Somebody that need to repent. Somebody that need to know that Christ, he died for you and he rose again. But he wants you to go to heaven. He wants you to know that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. This couldn't be a better day for somebody to surrender, because you can't make a change by yourself. God got to change a man's heart. Your heart got to be changed today. You can change your ways, you can change your act, but if your heart is wicked, you're still going to do wicked things. So we don't need God to change the outside, we need him to change the inside. So I don't know who under the sound of my voice today, but if you out here today and you say, my breath leave my body, I don't know where I go. I want to give you an opportunity. I want to present Jesus to you today. And I'm not going to ask you to come forward, because this between you and God. But you know in your own heart, if you die right now, you don't know where you'll go. And there's only two places. You're either going to heaven or you're going to hell. And I know we don't like that word hell, but there's only two places. So I want to give somebody an opportunity right now. And I need everybody to bow your heads right now. And if you out here today and you say, you know what, being out here today, I didn't recognize, I didn't understand, I didn't think you can serve God and worship God in a time like this. But I see something on the inside of these people out here that I don't have. And I want it today. How can they shout when this didn't happen? How can they do that? Because it's the strength of God. So if you out here right now, when you say, that's me, pray for me. I want to change. I need a heart transplant. I need Jesus to come into my life. I just need you to lift up your hand and wave it. Hallelujah. Just wave a hand to me. I see a couple of hands, several hands out here today. If you want that today, I want to pray a prayer with you. And I don't need you to pray the prayer to me, because I had to pray it myself. Because the Bible says all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. So if you out here today and you lifted your hand, the Bible says if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shall be saved. Not you might be saved, you shall be saved. For those of you that lift your hands, here go the prayer right here. Say, Lord Jesus, I confess that I'm a sinner and I need a Savior. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Change me. I believe you raised Jesus from the dead. And Lord, he took my place. And right now, I thank him. I give him praise. I give him glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, it happened. If your mouth and your heart came in agreement, a miracle just took place. So as we begin to light the candle to represent Sadie Roberts Joseph, that she truly was a light. And that's what Jesus said about us. We are the light of the world. If you're born again, you're the salt of the earth. So if you have your candle today, do we have any more? Somebody say, that's power. I break every curse, Lord. Break every chain. Break every chain today. Break every chain today, God. Break every chain today, God. Come on, hold your candle up. We're going to begin to light it. Find the person next to you with one lit already and begin to rise in the light. My God. There's an that's rising up. There's an army rising up today. Ain't saying that there's an army rising up today. streets, we tell the devil, no more killing. Over the young men, over the young ladies.
Break every chain.
Break every chain today.
There is power, say. There is power.
Hold it up. Hold it up.
Come on, army of the Lord, praise Him.
There's power. There's power. Somebody say power. So Father, we thank you.
Just to break every chain.
To set the captives free. To take away the hurt and the pain. Break it. Break it in Jesus' name. Yeah, God. Where the army is. Come on. We break it today. We break it today. We break it in the spirit today. Hallelujah, God.
Somebody release it into the
atmosphere. Nobody will leave you the same, God. Nobody will leave you the same, God. I hear a sound. Anybody hear a sound today? I say I hear a sound today. I say I hear a sound today. Hey, God. In Baton Rouge. In the pump. Oh God, everywhere. The four corners of Louisiana, God. Let the chains begin to fall, God. Let the chains rise up, God. Shout it with everything in you.
I hear the chains.
Hallelujah, Lord God. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. Hallelujah. We bless your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now may the grace of God be with you. May His love, may His joy, may His peace, may His angels be around you. May He follow you home. May what you experience here today overtake you. Those that accepted Christ, I encourage you to find a church and get in it. Tell somebody you've been born again. Begin to read the word of God. Begin to separate yourself from your old friend. And I guarantee you, your life will never be the same. And we say to God be the glory for everything that took place, everything that happened out here today. So with one more hand lifted up, we say good night. We say from our family to yours, we love you. She said, roll up your sleeve and let's go to work. The celebration of Sadie Roberts. Joseph, give it up. Give it up. You are listening.
Thank you.
sleep and let's get to work.